Next question is from Jenny Chapman, 356. Can you speak to how fitness isn't selfish? As a mom, I really struggle with this.
Yeah, this is a big challenge
it can be.
For parents, especially moms.
It can be, though.
Okay, depends how you use fitness. Are you using it to escape, or are you using it to improve yourself and make you...
include others.
Right, and better at what you do. So, you know that saying, you can't pour from an empty cup?
Mm-hmm.
If you're unhealthy, if you're not fit, you are not going to be as effective as a mom or as an employee or as a partner because, I mean, look, if you feel like crap, you're just not as good at handling bad and stressful situations. You're probably more likely to self-medicate with other things. You're not going to be your best self. You're the best version of yourself. A fit and healthy you is the best everything else that you could possibly do because you're fit and healthy. It doesn't guarantee that. It just means you're in a position to be even better at those things. But if you work out to avoid and escape, you know, if you're like, oh, sorry, got to go work out again. Sorry, got to work out again. And you're doing this because you don't want to be around your husband or you don't want to deal with your kids. And I get there's a natural component to this, by the way. A little bit of that is totally normal. Like we all do this where we're like, I got to get out of the house for a second. I get that.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's this chronic thing, then yeah, it could definitely become selfish. But again, if you're doing it to make yourself healthier, it's an investment in everything. You know, like I don't want a partner who doesn't take care of their health because I know how much worse that's going to make everything else. It just is. It's a fact. So fitness done right in a healthy way is not selfish at all.
It's all the mentality going into it and the psychology behind it. Like if you're in it to better yourself and to improve and to grow and to make sure that you have that kind of energy and stamina to play with your kids and to be chipper and lively around your family and friends, like it benefits all those things, but there's a structure behind that you need to consider. And, you know, it can get to a point where we focus on the wrong things where like, you know, it's all body focused or it's all like, the aesthetics and it's all just like, I'm not getting this and I hate my body because it feels flabby here. And, you know, it becomes this like, obsession.
Yeah.
And that's something that, can happen. And so you could see how that would become like a selfish endeavor once we start focusing on those things versus like how to, you know, really improve all the other aspects.
I think when you look at the social media landscape, I would actually make the case that a majority of the people fitness influencers out there are actually selfishly motivated.
Mm.
Yeah.
So, although I think it's important,
it's
want to
insecurity driven, isn't
that's
it?
That's right. Mm-hmm. So I think what you have to be very aware on if it's because you're like we talked about that study where you could take a whole week off straight in your training routine and get just as good of results as the person who trains every single day. So if there is this, you know, oh, I've built this routine, I never miss, I go 5 days a week and this time and you have that and your wife or your husband tells you like, hey, you know, honey, I want to talk to you, you know, have dinner, just some things have been on my mind, this and that. Oh, that's, yeah, can you do it another time? Because that's my time of working out.
Or your kid has a baseball game.
That's right. If you start making these decisions that sacrifice other parts of health in pursuit of what you call your health goals with fitness, but is really driven because of your insecurities about your body, it can be very selfish. And I saw this in competing. I think that competing was one of the most selfish things that I ever done in my life. My whole life revolved around my food choices, my training times, my sleep, and I made everybody else around me adapt, you know, so that's very selfish. So I think there's definitely a balance here, but I also think it can be very unselfish to not take care of yourself. So not taking care of yourself can be very selfish in comparison to being there for your partner. You already said it, Sal, that when you are healthy, you're a better husband, you're a better father, you're just a better person, a better employee, a better boss. Like, so it can be very selfish to not. So there's this fine dance between the two of them.
Yeah, I know for me, and this is just something I'm more aware of now more than ever, the mental benefit for me is probably the most important. I think I am, and because I've been exercising for so long, consistently, I've done a really good job of treating myself naturally for things like anxiety and depression, which I think I might be prone to. I think this is something that might actually might have issues to, these ups and downs. And regular exercise is really good for me in that particular sense. So, and I know when I miss, and I miss for a few days, I start to feel these kind of mental effects. So it's real important. But the challenge is exactly what you're saying, Adam, is this more of a selfish thing, or is this benefiting me? I mean, I just recently had an issue with this because the place that we live in now, you know, I would work out in the garage in the early morning, but the garage is literally right underneath the baby's room, and I'd wake him up. And so, you know, Jessica's like, you can't, if you work out in the morning, he's going to wake up. And I had struggled with this, pissed off. No, I'll do it quietly. I'll do it. But I had to accept it. Like, it's true. Like, I'm going to wake him up. And so I got to find an alternative. And so what I do is you guys see me, I scram over here and I do an hour workout in 35 minutes some weeks when that's just the way it's going to have to be. Mm. But that was tough for me. That was tough for me because there's a selfish component too, which is like, I got to get, you know, it's got to be my workout. So this depends. This depends. Mm-hmm. But I tell you what, if you have a really good partner that you trust and they say to you, hey, your workouts are starting to become a little selfish, as hard as that is to hear, you might need to kind of consider that maybe they're telling you the truth, you know, yeah. Consider that.